Hello, Sagittarius. Welcome to your monthly reading for October 2022. This is for Sagittarius Sun and Rising. And if you're new to my channel, I do a traditional Celtic cross spread. But I also use astrology and my guides to help bring a lot more clarity, get more specific with your reading. I do this so you feel like it's more like a personal reading, like we're here one-on-one, rather than a general spread. Now, Sagittarius, October is a huge, huge, huge month, all right? The first 3 weeks dipped in gold. All right, we have some beautiful alignments. We have some beautiful trines. We have that extremely powerful full moon in Aries on October 9th. All right, and we know Jupiter is in Aries. And the reason why this is a powerful full moon, especially for you, Sagittarius, is because all the inner planets, Mercury, Mars, Venus, even the Sun, they're all harmonious with, this is a really, really good one. And it falls in your fifth house. We know Jupiter, the planet of good luck and fortune, is in your fifth house already. So that is your fifth house of love, of creativity. If you've been needing that dose of inspiration, it's also family and children. So both ancient and modern astrologers alike, listen, we love that fifth house. It's such a fun house, all right? One of my favorite houses. It happens, and you have a lot of attention there, all right? Another reason October is big is Mercury goes direct. Saturn goes direct. Pluto goes direct. Boom, boom, boom. Things are going to go at light speed now if you thought September was slow and not a lot happened, all right? Delays, miscommunication. It could have been a really funky month, all right? That's a weird word now that I said it out of my mouth, but I haven't said that in a long time. But yeah, and lastly, Sagittarius, we have that huge, 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 huge solar eclipse in Scorpio at the end of the month. This is big, all right? It's really big. Also, Jupiter re-enters Pisces, Mars goes retrograde. Last week, really, really big. So when I say it's a big month, it's a big month. Now, if you're new to my channel, I leave all the key astrological dates in my description box if you want to follow along. And lastly, stay to the end of the reading because I pull a card a week just to give you a little bit more insight on what to expect for every week this month. Again, it is a loaded month. And so it's just really helpful to know what you're getting into, how to just go with it each week. All right, so let's go ahead and get started with your spread for October 2022. Now, Sagittarius, like I said earlier, I do a traditional Celtic cross spread. It's what my clients prefer. If you want to book a private reading, you know where to find me. Secondly, Sagittarius, I love you so much, okay? I love you, and you know that. If you are a subscriber, I say that every week. I love all my Sagittarians. Y'all are so fun and full of life and full of adventure. And every time I'm around like Sagittarians, I have a lot of Sagittarian friends. Y'all are so optimistic. And it's just the energy that y'all have. You're so fiery. And y'all know that, okay? You know that you lift a lot of people's spirits. So thanks for being you, Sagittarius. Love ya. Now, Here's an interesting spread, all right? I'm not gonna lie. We've come to something interesting here, okay? So let's get started. You got the Three of Cups. So I love this energy for you. Remember, I said there's a lot of activity with your family that's been happening. And this is a card of sisterhood and brotherhood if you do have brothers and sisters. Not limited to that too, as well. Friends, all right? So you could have had some really good moments, bonding moments with your family, with friends, with, you know, your girlfriends or your pack and your squad. I love that. You had a lot to celebrate recently, okay? There could have been some really good news that you had come into, maybe even your friend, someone got pregnant, because listen, this isn't just about celebration. It's not just about sisterhood and brotherhood. It is the birth of ideas. It's the three, all right? Three, creation, but also advancement, growth, development. So I really love that. Where we're coming from. Okay, Sagittarius, now, speaking of threes, you did get the Three of Swords in the heart of your spread. So there is going to be something that happens this month where you may feel a little heartbreak, all right? I'm not going to lie. And listen, it is not going to be something where, here's the thing. Looking at the rest of your spread, this is something that's going to be more like, leaving something that was close to you, if that makes any sense. Let me give you an example. You lived in the same house or apartment or neighborhood for 5 years. You had your crew, you knew your neighbors, everything was cool. You met a dude, you met a girl, you're gonna move in with them, maybe a different city, different neighborhood. So you're leaving that behind, all those memories, and that's hard, okay? That is the energy that I'm getting here with the Three of Swords. Now, listen, even though this is considered the heartbreak card, and it is an enlarged heart here, it's still a sword, okay? The mental suit. So it is almost like things are going to, you may lose a little bit of focus. There could be, it might be hard for you to move forward. But again, looking at your spread, there's nothing here indicating that this is going to be something that is truly more challenging than it should be. It's more of like, it's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday kind of energy, all right? There is going to be a lot to, you're coming from a place of celebration and you're moving into a place of major celebration. So before I even get there, you got the Page of Swords in your challenge area. The Page of Swords is new energy. Again, the mental suit, okay? And this is the newbie, all right? I love this guy. He is the first person in the world to ever have the man bun, right? He is so eager, so adventurous, so ready to get going. Mind just ready, 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 all right? Almost in an annoying way. You know, like the, I don't know, like when, I've made this analogy before, when you go camping, all right, when you're, or even going on a hike with your friends, and after like, you've hiked 14 miles, and you want to take a 20 minute break, and everyone agrees, there's that one person, 2 minutes, and it's like, all right guys, let's go, come on, we're ready, that's him, a lot of enthusiasm. So, when it comes up in your challenge area, hello, don't lose it, all right? Don't remember what I said from the very beginning, Sagittarius. Y'all are so inspiring. Don't lose that spark, all right? Don't let this lose your, don't lose your spark. Don't lose who you are in the moment, all right? Anything that may happen where you have to leave something behind, and something, it could even be something that you were just very mentally attached to, all right? Something that was, I keep getting like travel too. So if you are moving, listen, it is hard to say bye to places. You know, I've moved a lot too. And you know, I've had friends leave, you know, best friends move into different cities. And you know, these moments are really heartbreaking, but you know, at the same time, I don't want you to lose that true spirit, all right? And that inspiring person that you are, all right? And that adventurous person that you are, all right? So, Page of Swords in the challenge area, I just want you to know that don't let this affect you, because, again, looking at your spread, you're good. Now, King of Wands, all right? Knight of Pentacles. In your crown, in your root, all right? I love this because it looks like you are, well, first of all, King of Wands, he is the most joyful. He's the most like Richard the Lion. It's just like, just so full of life, right? He's also like the king that's like, it's almost like a Judd Apatow movie. It's like, there's the guy who, I don't know, Owen Wilson plays a character where all of a sudden, they make him king. He's like, what? I'm king? Like, what? You know, like a Adam Sandler movie. But then when he becomes king and sits on that throne, he kills it. He nails it. Everybody loves him. Everybody loves this king. He is so good to his people. All right. Now, I love that you got the King of Wands because this is very entrepreneurial energy as well. I do call him the Steve Jobs of tarot because very inspiring. People looked up to him. He didn't have to work for anybody else. He earned his place in this throne. Very fiery energy, very transformative energy, and you are looking for that, all right? This isn't just career, though. This is career, jobs, side hustles, and your passions, ideas, all of that, all right? We know where your head's at. Now, Knight of Pentacles, love him, all right? The only knight, listen, knights are really fiery, all right? Pentacles, all about money, wealth, but very earthbound, tangible realities, physical reality. Now, this is the only knight where the horse is just not going anywhere. And so there's a reason for that. You know, all the other knights, their horses are charging forward or moving forward. There's a reason for that. And it is because this is a card of long-term commitment, all right? This is a card of sowing your seeds, reaping the rewards, no matter how long it takes, all right? Patience. And that's what you're looking for now, all right? You're looking for that in your life, almost like making this investment into something, whether it is, you know, career related, maybe you're getting serious about your career. Maybe you got a job that you really love and you want to, you know, you're in it for the long haul. Maybe you entered even, you know, a relationship or you bought a car. I know that's really silly, but maybe you bought a car and you're like, oh my God, I love this car and it's going to last me so long, but this is the car that gets me to see, you know, my partner who lives, you know, 40 miles away, and that's the, you know, keeps us together, and eventually we're going to move in together. But anyway, just think long-term commitment here. That's in the root of your spread, all right? And I really love that, and it will bring you that wealth in so many areas of your life. Now, as I said earlier, look at your future. You got the Six of Wands, all right? This is victory. This is success. This is public recognition. This is honors, all right? This is you being celebration. This is being a celebrated moment. You can see the people cheering him on. That's you, all right? You can also notice the horse isn't done. Not like that one. He's still going, all right? You're on your way to many victories and successes, all right? So this here, I don't want you to worry about it, all right? There is another sign that actually got it in the heart of their spread, and they had a very different spread as well. But this really is just a moment to learn from a situation, to grow from it, and to become stronger, okay? And it is just something that happens in life, okay? Remember, think about threes, all right? Growth, advancement, development, but also creation. Think about cycles, all right? Birth, life, death. I mean, this really is a growing experience, and with growing experience, there are sometimes growing pains, but again, this is more for you, if that makes any sense, okay? Now, Sagittarius, let's get to your staff. Sagittarius, if you like this reading so far, it would be great if you like and subscribe. If you are a subscriber, you know I can't say that word, but thank you so much for being here with me every week. You know I really love you, and if you are new to my channel, it would be just so great. It really does help my channel grow. All right, awesome. Now, Sagittarius, I have to tell you, when I said things are going to move fast, things are going to move fast, okay? Things are going to move fast, especially in a partnership. If you're in a partnership, I am getting both love and career, okay? And when I say career, your relationship with your boss and like colleagues. But let's go ahead and get started. You did get the Nine of Wands, all right? So it looks like you're ready to get over something anyway, all right? You're ready to get to the end of something. This is all about resilience. This is someone who's just gone through it, all right? He's at the nines now, all right? We're at the nines. Now, you can see that he's a little beat up. He's a little, you know, on guard, right? Listen, here's the thing. And let me pull my look at this. I'm pulling my seat up like I'm a coach or something. This is, remember in elementary school when your math teacher had that cat poster, the cat hanging from the tree? This is that card. This is the hang in there, don't give up. You've got this, okay? Resilience, persistence. This is you making it. You're so close. 10 is a completion, right? You're so close to it. So if you feel like you have been challenged, going through a challenging situation, which, hey, you did get the Three of Swords, it's going to be over before you know it, all right? Now, you did get the Seven of Cups in your external factors area. It looks like you will be getting some opportunities come through. That's good news. I want you to know, even though Mercury is going retrograde, direct, and Pluto, and, well, Neptune's still going to be retrograde, which, you know, can explain this card, but listen, Seven of Cups, you can see that the universe is gifting him so many different options here, but take a close look. You can see they're not all that great, all right? Snake coming out of one. There's a dragon out of the other. They're all very different. There's beauty in one. There's, you know, you see the laurel, the wreath in the other. They're so different. So you may have a lot of options come through. You may have a lot of opportunities come through. You may have a lot of suitors come through. Just be careful about what you want, all right? Be very careful about the decisions that you make, and boom, when you trust your gut, when you make the right decision, you get the Ace of Wands. I am surprised that came up, and I'm very happy for you. So a lot of y'all Sagittarians are in pursuit of your passions right now, all right? This is really interesting because, I mean, you're pulling a lot of wands here, but Ace is, out of all the minor arcanas, ushers in the most new change, the most new opportunity, okay? Wands, again, this could be a new job that you're getting, all right? You could be getting a new job. You could be starting a side hustle. But again, remember, wands, passions, right? Passions, ideas. Some of your ideas could start taking off now, all right? This is really great. Came in your external factors area. That's why just be very careful with opportunities that come about. Know what you want, all right? One last thing I'm going to tell you, okay? Because you have more wands coming up. Before I even get there, you see the thumbs up from the Hand of Spirit, all right? You're good to go. Secondly, the most important thing, this wand, wands represent fire. You're a fire sign. You know all about it. This wand represents fire, okay? This wand is alive. It's the only tool in tarot that's alive, all right? Look at it sprouting leaves, all right? This is the birth of new things, okay? Now, pentacles. Do leaves grow out of pentacles? No. Cups? No. Swords? No. This is alive. Remember, fire. Think of this as a spark. I want you to turn this, your passions, your ideas, everything that you want into a blazing inferno, all right? You have the power. It's going to happen. You also got the world, all right? Sagittarius, you got the world. And I love that because it's indicating that you are ready. You are ready to move forward. You are ready to get all this victory and success and public recognition, even just from your friends and your family, but you're ready to end one chapter of your life and move forward, okay? This is really great. I love this. I love this new opportunity coming through. And like I said, lastly, when I said things are gonna move really fast for you, things are gonna move really fast for you, all right? You did get the Eight of Wands. Now, this is the only card in tarot where there is no figure, there is no person, there's no symbol. It's literally eight wands zipping through the air, indicating things are going to move really fast. If there's anything that you're working on, if you're in a relationship, things could just start moving a lot faster, especially now that Mercury's gone direct. Things are going to, and this is in your final outcome area, all right? A lot of y'all may be traveling too, all right? Keep that in mind, Sagittarius. A lot of y'all could be traveling, and I love that for you. Even, you know, especially as we are in Libra season, that which does rule your 11th house, okay? So there's a lot of friends, networking, community activity happening right now. But 11th house rules our hopes and dreams. So it's almost like that's being fast-tracked right now. But it's what but for some, but again, travel. Y'all may have to travel, and that has been a recurring thing and message that's been coming through throughout your whole reading anyway. So some of y'all, and I'm not getting like huge long distance, but some of y'all may be traveling at some point this month. Now, as I promised, I am going to pull a card a week just to give you a little bit more insight and clarity what to do for each week, what to expect for each week. The first week of October is great. Mercury's going direct. Pluto's going direct. I love that Mercury's trining Pluto too, but what have we got here? Yes, the Seven of Wands. This is really interesting. The Seven of Wands have come up in a lot of readings this week, all right? Or for this month, okay? And so I'm not surprised, especially with September being probably the slowest month in the year because six planets were retrograde. But even still, there could have been a lot of confusion. There could have been a lot of miscommunication. But here is you standing your ground, claiming your territory, defending everything that you've worked for. So there is a possibility that people could be jealous of you for some reason or another, because if you think about it, listen, you got the Six of Wands here. Seven of Wands comes after the Six of Wands. So when we are victorious, when we are successful, when things go our way, people tend to be jealous, and that's why they attack like these people with these other wands. But you're doing a damn good job defending yourself. If you feel that you need to the first week, you have nothing to sweat. You'll be fine, all right? You will be fine. Now, the second week, that full moon in Aries. Oh, I love it. I love that full moon in Aries. And again, that is your fifth house, Sagittarius. So what can we expect? Oh, you got the Four of Swords. That's great. Okay. Especially coming after the Three of Swords here. So good time to heal. All right. Good time to heal. Have some mental clarity. Now, this is, you can see that he has his hands in prayer here. One thing that I'm going to say just real quickly, this is a card of meditation. And I know that's a strong word for some people. Stillness of mind, all right? So have some mental clarity the second week, because things are, remember, going to move really fast for you, all right? Things are going to move really fast, especially, again, with partnerships, because Mars is in Gemini, and it's fiery, especially third week of October. Mars is, oh my goodness, Mars is active. Mars is trining the Sun. Venus is trining Mars. I mean, there's a lot going on, so let's see what's going on. Okay, you got strength. Wow. All right, so Sagittarius, find that inner strength, third week of October. Listen, I don't do reversals, and I know that came out under reversals or reversed, but I don't do reversals because every card has its shadow side and a light side, and everybody knows that. But I read it as it is and as the messages come through. But here's the one thing. That's why I say find that strength, okay? It's not going to come to you. Find it. And in order to find that strength, you can see that she is taming the lion here, all right? Now, this is not her taming the lion. This is the lion letting her tame, okay? What does that mean? This is their interaction, all right? This is a harmonious interaction. Now, think of the lion as your spirit animal. Whatever you find strength in, whether it's God, whether it's the universe, whether it's your children, whether it's your family, find that strength through them right now. All right, third week of October. Now the last week, September, Sagittarius, we are moving into your 12th house. 12th house is the subconscious, all right? It is the, hidden enemies, secrets, all that. But I like the 12th house. People find a lot of solitude there. It's almost like spring cleaning, well, fall cleaning, since we're in fall season. But let's see what's going on for you with all that activity. Oh yeah, you did get the Devil. All right, so listen, I want you to know the main message that's coming through. Listen, the Devil represents our vices, okay? It represents our deepest, darkest desires. It represents bad behaviors, bad habits that we can't let go. Now, sometimes we want something so bad, we'll do anything for it, all right? Think of those movies where people will do anything for the thing that they really want. So with this coming up in Scorpio, We're the last week of October, where all those planets are in your 12th house. Scorpio is your 12th house in your subconscious. This is a really good time to get rid of anything that does not serve you at this point. Anything that does not serve you, all right? It's almost like a cleansing. Remember, that's what I said, cleansing, like a purging. Just get rid of anything that does not serve you, and you will know what it is, all right? You won't have to, you will know, all right? It'll be one of those weeks, okay, where you're just going to learn, all right? You'll figure it out. But other than that, listen, remember, your path forward is clear as day here, all right? A lot of victory, a lot of success, a lot of opportunities, and a beautiful new opportunity coming through, okay? Things are going to move really fast for you, and all of these, like the heartbreak energy, defending yourself, all of that is coming to an end. You're fine, Sagittarius. I'm excited for you for October. And listen, I talk way too much, so I'm going to go ahead. That was your reading. Claim it. This is great. Listen, Sagittarius, I love you so much. You know I love you. Again, if you're new to my channel, it would be great if you like and subscribe. And if you're a subscriber, I will see you next week, and I love you so much. Thanks so much. I'll see you soon. Bye.